So you want to learn web development in 2025, but haven't you heard the social media influencers say AI will take your job? Like, look at the code forces and SWE benchmark scores of OpenAI's O3 model. How do we stand against that? Also, the GitHub CEO said that they will open this coding field to everyone, with their goal being to create a world where everyone can code in natural language and build production level apps. Additionally, in 2025 and beyond, the coding space will be full of AI agents like Devin and Replit and more. So you still want to learn web development and make the most of it? Well, if you ask me the same question, what would I do in that situation? Where I would start if I had to start learning web development in 2025? Is this the best time or are we late? Well, I'm going to answer each one of your questions one by one. So, in fear of AI taking the job and replacing developers, if new developers stop learning to code, the new tech innovation will suddenly stop. Because it's not about writing the code, it's about solving a specific problem. Creative enough to ease some process and automate things. So yes, this is the best time to learn code. Think it like you are in a job and you have to solve an unseen bug, which has created problem to the app since months. Now as a developer, you have to think about the problem, break them into steps, find a unique way to solve the problem, which will benefit the application. Now this requires insane critical thinking and creativity. You can't rely on any AI for this. But after you sort out all the steps, your next step is to write the code. So now you can give prompt to any AI which will write the code for you according to your requirement. Also, if you know how to code, then here if AI do any mistakes, then there is a higher chance that you could fix the coding problem too. So is this the right time to learn web development? Absolutely yes. So you are wondering, where do I start? Maybe you have zero knowledge of web development, but you really want to build web apps. What should you do first? First thing, stop listening to the noise. Forget about what others say, especially influencers who scare you with talk of AI taking over. Stop worrying about competing with others who already know more. If you are dedicated, you can start anywhere in web development. It's an open field. But yes, there is a step-by-step approach. First learn HTML, then CSS, then JavaScript, then React, and then finally Next.js. But here is the thing. If you want to jump straight to the Next.js, you can. But you have to be brave enough to let yourself take that leap. If I were in your shoes, I would probably start with Next.js right after building a simple static website with HTML and CSS. However, to really maximize your learning, I would question everything I don't understand, no matter how simple it seems. For example, when you start learning Next.js, you will come across things like app router, page router, server-side rendering, client-side rendering, and a lot more new terminology. Whenever I come across something I don't understand, I would simply dig into AI tools or official documentation to find out more. What does this term mean? Why is it used? How does it work? This way, you will not only catch up with the latest features, but also cover anything you might have missed along the way. Where should I start learning? If I were you in 2025, I would start with YouTube tutorials and the official documentation for the first week. Once I'm comfortable with the basics, I would switch to reading docs and using AI tools for the next week. Then after about 2-3 weeks, I will start writing code on my own. This will help you become more fluent in coding and build self-confidence. Sure, AI can write your code, but in the learning phase, you need to challenge yourself and think critically. Doing this will pay off when AI tools make mistakes in the future. You will know how to fix them. Do you need to buy any web development course? My answer is simple, no. You have free access to all the best information through AI tools. Use them to your advantage. And if you are not confident in English, no problem. AI tools can work with you in your native language too, so don't hesitate to use them as much as possible. How long will it take to master web development? This depends on you. It's all about your learning pace and how much projects you build. The more projects you build, the better. I recommend 15 to 20 projects with 5 to 10 solid ones that really showcase your skills. The timeline could be anywhere from 3 months to a year. It's totally up to you. Remember, web development is always evolving, so even experienced developers need to keep learning. If you enjoy the process of continuous learning, you will do great in this field. What about burnout and mental breakdowns? Let's face it, burnout is a real thing. You will face challenges like bugs you can't fix and problems that seem impossible to solve. In the beginning, it might feel overwhelming, but don't give up. Take a break, have a cup of coffee, and then get back to it. Remember, it's you versus you, not you versus AI or anyone else. The journey is about getting better every day, and the challenges will only make you stronger. So stay patient and keep going. You have got this. Bye.